McQuade. I live in Cincinnati, Ohio. So I grew up in Oxford, so just north of here, and we grew up all the time going down into the creek beds and basically looking at rocks, hunting fossils, you know, just finding what treasures we could find. And I always thought that that was everybody's childhood. I just thought everybody went to a creek and looked for fossils, and they found fossils all the time, and everybody had fossils everywhere. When I moved back to Cincinnati, and during the lockdown, I basically was looking for something to do in my backyard and started walking in the creek bed and realized there are all these fossils like I used to see when I was little. And suddenly I was like, this can't be everywhere. And sure enough, I looked it up, and it was suddenly like the discovery that Cincinnati is the hotbed of fossil hunting. And it's a very specific area of Ordovician fossils that are 450 million years old. You go down there and you can see fossils nonstop. And I realized it was something I could do every day. I got a walk in, so I got to go down and exercise. And I started finding all these fossils and really researching them and learning what they all were. And it just became a real hobby. It's like treasure hunting. So 450 million years ago, Ohio, this part of Ohio, used to be under a seabed. It was a very sort of shallow, sea reefy type area with all these coral things back before there were living things with legs. So these were all kind of sea plants. And when that dried up, suddenly the, I don't know the exact science, but suddenly everything became dried up and calcified, and everything became mineralized. You'll have to ask a scientist about that. I'm just an amateur. I just like to find them, but I do like to research about them. That's why I have the books, though, so I can figure out what everything is and how they were formed. It's interesting because once you start looking down there, you realize what's very common and you realize what's uncommon. Your eyes start to get tuned to shapes. By far the most common things are brachiopods. So they're the ones that look like seashells. So they're really identifiable. I mean, you see seashells in a creek bed in Ohio, you wonder how they got there. So you see a lot of those. There are some that are the full clam shape. So lots and lots of brachiopods, to the point where fossil hunters sort of tend to leave them there. I pick them up if they're pretty perfect. So I have a lot of brachiopods. And then there are these ones that have, they kind of look like, I used to call these coral before I started learning, but these are actually bryozoans. And there are some that, this is my favorite actually. It's called the Constellaria bryozoan, and it has a star shape in it. And I don't remember, but I think they sort of filter water through those, or back when they were underwater. Gastropods, which are the ones that look like snails, those are really identifiable too. They're small though, so you have to have your eye tuned to the small little thing, but you start to see the world when you're down there. The most exciting ones to me are these are cephalopods. One of these, I think it was this one, cephalopods. So the first time I found this in the creek, I thought it was some kind of industrial screw or something like that. It sort of has this shape that has like a swirl pattern on it that looks like a big bolt or something. But it was like the smooth top, and I researched it and I found these are cephalopods, which is basically like a squid or an octopus now are called cephalopods. But these were 450 million year old squids. And I was really excited. So I started finding lots of these. And once your eye is tuned to it, you find them all over the place. And then this horn coral I actually didn't find in our creek. The horn corals are a little bit north of here. These are the ones we used to find all the time in Oxford. Fine, but I've never found one here that I can remember. The most exciting thing to find is actually the Isotelus trilobite. Trilobites, typically when people think of them, they think of like the little curled up one, and I have not found one of those. My 5-year-old nephew came here for the first time fossil hunting and found a little rolled up trilobite, and I was blown away. His eyes were just tuned to it. He found it. What I tend to find are pieces of trilobites. So like this is the mouthpiece of a trilobite, and they used to like crawl along the seafloor and eat. They're sort of like sweepers. They're kind of, they're related to a modern crab or the little roly-polies you see under rocks. Like those are related to trilobites somehow, I believe. But you find pieces of them, and they're really distinct because they're a sort of reddish brown color. And so when you're down in the creek, you can see them pretty much right away. And then when you're in the creek, you'll see huge rocks that you can't even bring up. But every once in a while, you'll get a slab like this that has just examples of every single imaginable fossil that Ohio has. And I really like these because they sort of are a representation of everything all in one place. And you can look at it for hours. It's like a painting or a sculpture that you can look at.